Boys, what a start it has been for Southampton. Josie, if I said to you, or would you have believed me, after the summer that happened, I said to you now, 12 games in, second in the league, about to play the champions who are below you in the table.
Yeah, I can't be hypocrite and say yes. Obviously, it was a very tough start in the preseason, especially we didn't have enough players. There was pictures on the social media and stuff.
From the manager, with no players.
Yeah, I must admit, it was. We all had doubts, for sure. But for me, the main thing was when we appointed Ronald Koeman, the gaffer. That was a very good indication that, okay, we have a very good manager in place. And then I think it was Dušan that came first and Pele, was it?
Yeah.
And immediately we saw, okay, we have two great players, so it's going on the right direction, and then the mood start changing. So, but still, you know, there was a lot of work to do, and the fact is that, you know, with a lot of work and very good organization and the manager and the staff, with all their hard work and preparing the team meticulously, we was able to start on a great way.
And what about you personally? If I said to you, maybe this time last year, you're going to be the captain, the team's going to be playing like this, and now you've made your Portugal debut as well.
Yeah, obviously, you know, I'm just over the moon because, yeah, I remember the tough days in League One. I remember, you know, the all the hard work that I have to do, and to be achieving this success now, and to be where we are now, is just great. I've worked hard for that, but I just want to keep going, because once you have the taste of it, you want more, and I want to improve. I want to be better, and that's what I will be trying to do: improve and be better every day.
And Dušan, to you, they say in the Premier League, when someone comes from abroad, it takes time to find your feet and settle down. Not you. Well, what's the secret? Why have you hit the ground running, as we say?
Yes, I think, yeah, it's really difficult. Some players, they never adapt, but I think also this is, I think coaches and all players, they are really important for that, because at first moment I feel really comfortable here, and I feel great atmosphere, great guys, and also coaches, everyone accept me really well, and me and other players, and then I think this is one of the biggest reasons why we adapt so quick.
How good is this guy?
Yeah, since day one, he surprised everyone. We didn't really know much about him, and you know, he only took one session to see that he had something special. So, yeah, he's been great for us, and he's a great professional above all, and a great guy. He's always in the gym doing his stuff, hey?
Yeah.
His abdominals and his stuff. And yeah, I just hope that he keeps fit, he keeps playing like he has been playing, because he's going to be very important for us until the end of the season.
Is he head of fashion at the club now, with the gear he's got on?
In that way, I can't say that he's top, but he will change, you know, he'll get better.
What about this guy though, Dušan? Because I remember, I think it might be 3 years ago, the players at the club said this guy spent, you know this, he spent more time in the mirror grooming, looking after his appearance than any other player at the club.
No, but he spent a little bit time, but not really.
I used to have long hair.
Yes.
Now we have other guys in front of the mirror.
But
come on, say it.
Grazie, I think he's Graziano.
Yeah. Hello,
yes, yes,
cold,
yes.
You know,
yes. Always here on the right place and everything.
All his shirts.
Yes, yes, everything.
He's a good-looking boy, to be fair.
Yes, well, yes.
You have to, you know, you have to be realistic.
Yeah,
you have to accept.
And what about when you arrived at the club? Because I imagine new players sing a song here, don't they? What did you do?
Yes, I sing one song, Serbian song. I think José don't like so much. They couldn't understand. This was good. But this was one Serbian song with a lot of emotions. But yeah, it's good that they
don't understand. So,
yes,
yeah.
It's good.
It's emotion, but
he sang it well?
No.
Bad voice.
Yeah. And Jose, what about the other guys settling in? It's not just him who settled in quickly. His link up with Pella, your partner,
like,
the
like
back
he said,
too.
Dad, like he said, we've been fortunate to have a great team spirit. I think you ask any player that comes in this club, in this group of players, what they feel, and they're gonna say, I feel immediately welcome at home. You know, we try and help them in everything they want, everything they need. The staff that works in here as well is amazing, and that's pretty much, you know, part of why they feel so easy and so quick at home. And after that, they can perform on the pitch because they feel straight away, I'm at home. You know, I'm comfortable. That's my opinion. At least it was what happened to me when I came. You know, I had Calvin Davis, which is a great leader. I had Dean Armand at the time was here. Other players, you know, all the players that has been. They spend so much time in this club, and you know, it's just great when you come here and you have this kind of people to welcome you and make you feel straight away at home.
Let's talk about the manager then, Ronald Koeman, who you would have known plenty about. He'd have known plenty about you. Was that a big factor in helping when you got here?
Yeah, honestly, this was one of the biggest factors why I came here, because I have a lot of offers from other countries and from other clubs. And yeah, it was really important for me, you know, when he called me and he told me what he want of me and what he like. And I know him from Holland. He makes so many players and they play really good football and everything. And I know him like coach. And then this was for sure one of the biggest reasons why I came here.
And what's he like? You must have a close relationship, I imagine, as captain and manager. To us, he's a legend as a player, and he comes across, particularly on television, as cool, doesn't he, really?
Yeah, he is. You know, first of all, he, like you said, he was a top player. You know, he played 6 years in Barcelona. He won everything. And sometimes he joins in and he's like...
Still good?
Still. He's better than some of us. So...
Still taking free kicks, I imagine, as well.
No, just passing.
Fair enough.
You know, he came in. He's a calm person. He's meticulous. He goes into the last detail. He organizes the team well. He has a great staff with him. And it's just great. You know, he has great philosophy. He knows what he wants from us. We know what we have to do. Everyone knows his job. And, you know, it has been fantastic so far. And I just hope that we can all keep going and keep working hard like this, because, you know, we have a great future in front of us.
What's he like as a captain? The skipper. Sorry? What's the skipper like as a captain? Does he shout? Does he rant? Is he calm?
No. He is a really good captain. And I told him already, not because we are now here. This is honestly... He always say right word, you know, and right moment. And when he say something, this is... honestly, in a lot of moments I want to say that, but you know exactly what it's our mind, you know. I think here everyone has same mind, and he always say that, you know, what we need to do, and always give us a lot of motivation and everything. And I think it's perfect captain.
And is he a captain that does it by what we say example, what he does on the field as a leader?
Yes, I think it's example, because he is one of the biggest professionals I know. Everything what he do. But brate, it's true, brate. No, he's serious. He's one of the biggest.
I didn't play
him, Ed. No, he's one of the biggest professionals, and this is for everyone example, you know. And also what I say, you know, when he says something, he have a lot of experience and also qualities. And then when he says something, this is like that, you know.
Like that. How much does being captain of this football club mean to you?
Well, first of all, I have to say, you know, Calvin Davis, which is the club captain, you know, I've learned so much from him, because he's been here for so many years, and I've been with him since the beginning, since we was in League One, and I've learned a lot from him, how to be a leader and how to, you know, to manage your teammates. And what I try to do is just, you know, be honest and try and motivate, like he said, try and make us believe, mentality, keep us together, because only like this we can achieve something great.
And as you know, on Super Sunday, Monday Night Football, the shows we do, we analyse Southampton and why Southampton are doing so well and the success you've had. What's been more important, Dušan? The attacking players or him and his defence?
No, we talk a lot of about that. I think it's everything, you know, because we attack together and we defend together, you know, and this is 11 players we defend and 11 players attack, you know, and this is our strength.
I think there's no me in our team, you know, there's us, you know, we all have to work hard together. And the manager puts emphasis on that. When you lose the ball, we need to work as a team, and with the ball, everyone together as well. So every player knows his job, knows that have to defend. The attackers are the first to react when we lose the ball. And that's very important, everyone helping defending. And then when we go forward, we have full backs playing amazing. We have the midfielders scoring goals. Dušan with so many assists, Pele with so many goals. You know, it's just, you know, it has been great to see how the team has performed.
And it's 6 goals conceded, which is incredible after 12 games, and something I'm sure you're proud of. But that goal on Monday night at Villa, did the goalkeeper Fraser Ford, did you need to pick him up a bit after that?
No, of course not. You know, he's an experienced guy. Everyone makes mistakes at any player will make mistakes, and the fact is that he's been amazing for us since the beginning of the season. You know, I'm 100% sure he'll give us a lot of points until the end. He made a small mistake, we didn't lose the game anyway, but he's been, in other games, he's been so important for us. You know, he's a calm guy, he's composed, you know, he's been great for us. So
the problem he's had is he hasn't had any shots to save.
Well,
it's true, isn't it?
Hopefully we can maintain that.
Yeah. And after the game, your manager spoke to us on Monday Night Football, and when I asked him, can you finish in the top 4? And he said, maybe top 3 even. Is there belief amongst the players that you can finish in the top 4 in the Premier League?
Yes, I think we just want to play game by game and to go highest as possible, you know. We now have a difficult schedule, and I think every game is difficult in Premier League. But we believe in our skills. We are good, like group and everything, and we work hard every day to be in top. And we're going to see end of the season what's going to be that.
What do you think, Jose?
Well, I think that, you know, in life you need to always aim for the best, and the manager has said it, and I'm not going to lie, the players talk about it, and it's something that we would like to achieve. But we also know it's extremely hard. We also know that you have a lot of teams that want to finish in the Champions League as well, a lot of teams that have spent a lot of money in great players. But one thing that we have is a great group, great team spirit. Everyone works for the same thing, and hopefully with no injuries as well, which will be a big part, no injuries, and maintaining this momentum going, and belief and the strong mentality, why not? You know, sometimes in life you have to dream big. If not, you're going to always fight for mid-table or relegation, and that's something that we don't want in this club. We want to fight for trophies, we want to fight for big things.
And throwing it forward, finally, I mean, you come to this country, I imagine you look forward to Manchester City, Arsenal, Manchester United. You've got them all in 10 days, and then Chelsea on the horizon as well. This is going to be some few weeks, Dušan, isn't it?
Yeah, it's going to be tough, but I think everyone like to play that kind of matches, and we want to show ourselves that we are good like team, and we believe what they say in our skills, and this is nice games, and we cannot expect that. We really like to play that games.
And Sunday's Manchester City, which means Font against Aguero.
Yeah.
How good is this guy right now?
He's been amazing. Obviously, we all see what he's been doing week after week, scoring so many goals. Last Champions League game, he scored a hat trick. He's one of the best strikers
in the
world at the moment. Of course.
Were you thinking, oh great, we got him at the weekend?
Yeah. I was hoping that he had a little knock, you know. You know, it's going to be hard, obviously, to defend against this kind of players. You always need the help of you know, in my case, Kleini next to me and Toby and the midfield, so we can help each other. But we have to be on our A game for sure to stop not only Aguero, but, you know, all the great players that City have. You know, they have too much quality to just worry about Aguero. Obviously, we know that he's on form, that he's scoring a lot of goals at the moment, but we need to analyze City as a team, and we need to work, especially ourselves, in concentrate in being organized, and like we have been doing so far, and hopefully we can stop it.
What makes him, you've played against him two or three times, Aguero, what makes him special and different to other strikers you come up against?
Yeah, I think the fact that he's short and his center of gravity is low, he turns too quick. For some of the defenders, he's too quick. He's sharp. He can go in behind you with his pace. He can come short and hold the ball well because he has strong legs. He's good on holding the ball. He's clever with his clever movement, and above all, he can finish any way he wants. So he's the complete striker in my opinion. And like I said before, you have to be on your A game and obviously have the help of your teammates as well.
And where does he stand, you think? Because you've played with Ronaldo now, with Portugal.
Yeah.
Well, where's Aguero in the pecking order?
Ronaldo is, for me, the best player I've played with. Aguero is going to be very, very close to Ronaldo, Messi, Suarez when he's on form. You know, Aguero at the moment is up there because he's fantastic. You know, what he's been doing is fantastic.
This will be you, Dušan, in a couple of years. Get right up there. Who's the best player in your opinion?
Yeah, but what you say, I think Messi and Ronaldo, what they do, this is not possible. And but serious, they are above everyone, and then rest of the players, like what Jose say, Suarez, Aguero, and a lot of good players. But I think Messi and Ronaldo, what they did, this is not normal.
So can Southampton win on Sunday? Manchester City at home.
Of course we can win, and but for that we need to do what we've been doing so far until last Monday. Obviously we didn't win that game, but still we was dominating, and I think if it was to be a winner, it would be us. But hopefully we can perform, everyone as a team, and we'll try and give a good go.
Good luck, boys. Cheers. Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you.
Dušan, thank you.
Cheers.